man, the myth. And how do you know a kung fu master is not a kung fu master? When he says he's a kung fu master. So he's not a kung fu master. He's a kung fu student extraordinaire and supreme. He is the musician, the martial artist, the myth, RZA!
One, two, one, two, one, two, yeah, yeah. Any Wu-Tang fans in the house?
Wow. Any Shaolin fans in the house? Yeah. Good lion. Anyway, RZA.
What's going on, Rick?
Buddy, I'm here to talk to you about your love of kung fu films, martial arts movies, right?
Guaranteed.
Right. When you started, everybody I know goes right for Bruce Lee. There you go.
I got my Bruce Lee t-shirt on today, all right?
Yeah, I got my Fist of Fury shirt on, but I also have my 36 Chamber of Shaolin watch on.
36 Chamber of Shaolin, director, Law Carlung.
Yeah, baby. And the point is, everybody was going for Bruce because he was mean and he had the muscles, but you went for Law Carlung. You don't do a concert about Enter the Dragon. You do a concert about 36 Chamber of Shaolin.
And I think it's because the spirituality that was also brought to the films. Kung Fu has a way of training your mind, your body, and your spirit. And even though Bruce Lee was the pioneer who brought Asian cinema to a worldwide stage, it was directors like Law Kar Young, Sun Chung, you know, that Chang Che, can't forget him.
Five Deadly Venoms,
who were making movies that didn't make it to the mainstream, but was building a culture and a cult following.
Yeah.
And I think that the kung fu spirit that I saw in 36 Chambers inspired me as a young man, watching that the Asian people in that film was going through a struggle. Check this out, I'm watching a kung fu movie, I think. And it's about a group of college kids who are realizing that the government is oppressing the people. And they decide to speak out. And when they speak out against the government, their entire family is killed. And it takes our hero, he leaves his village as a fugitive, runs away, and he goes to a place called Shaolin Temple, where he learns the mental, physical, and spiritual discipline to come back and teach the people. So when I saw that, that became an inspiration to my life, because, you know, being black in America, especially as I was growing up, you know, the feeling of oppression, the feeling of being outcast, the feeling of not having a voice was part of my life. You know, I didn't learn black history in school. I had to go find Malcolm X books. But watching 36 Chambers and seeing that this same situation resonated with other cultures around the world, it caused me to be highly attracted. And eventually I took that movie and watched it many times. And it became the name of my very first album that I did with the Wu-Tang Clan called Enter the 36 Chambers. And the rest of it became hip-hop, music, kung fu history.
Yeah, man. And also, it became my history, because when that came out, you didn't see the Doobie Brothers doing an album like that. You didn't see anything like that. So when that came out, I went, yeah. So it went into your music. Where did you see the movie in the first place?
I saw it on a place called 42nd Street in New York City, Times Square. Anybody know about that place? Anybody watching that new TV show called The Deuce?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, that's where it took place. That they had a lot of kung fu black exploitation film double features, and I would play hooky and go watch movies, and I saw it there.
Yeah, and did you continue with La Calle Young and the rest of it, and did it continue to inspire your music?
Definitely. I mean, from he did movies like Spiritual Boxer,
right.
Legendary Weapons of Shaolin, Shaolin Mantis, Eight Diagram Pole Fighter, My Young Auntie,
Mad Monkey.
Oh, cool.
Mad Monkey. I met My Young Auntie. I'll show you the picture of me with her later.
That's a pretty, she's a pretty lady.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Cara Hoy.
Bon. See, one thing we got here, Rick has wrote in many books about martial arts, movies, kung fu movies. So if anybody want to get a good foundation on which movies to watch, definitely grab one of his books. But we should point something out here, Rick.
Yeah.
Martial arts has permeated the entire movie going system. Like, I mean, the whole system is now infiltrated by martial arts. When you start looking at movies like Bourne Identity, you're watching martial arts at work. When you start looking at like all our great movies now, I'm a big Marvel fan. How many Marvel fans in the building? How many DC fans in the building?
Well, the biggest moment in Kung Fu of the last year was in Wonder Woman and Doctor Strange.
Exactly. And those martial arts styles and movies have found a new way to meld into our cinema. So when you see Captain America in that elevator,
yeah,
and he you know, he whips ass. Or even if you watch Mission Impossible with Tom Cruise, all these things, it's so great to see that martial arts is now part of our movie culture, and it enhances the movie going experience. So can we make some noise for martial arts inside movies?
And make some noise for kung fu inside of films too, because kung fu means human achievement and good work. And it's a higher elevated form, which is what you are a master of.
Now say that again. Say that again, Rick. Kung fu means?
In China, wushu means martial arts. In China, kung fu as translated means human achievement.
Exactly.
Good work.
And so the lesson for that is that you don't have to throw a punch or throw a kick or do a flip to be doing kung fu. It's your strive and your achievement, your energy in motion. Whether you're doing that from writing, from dancing, from making music, you are expressing what will be translated into kung fu.
Ooh, yeah, baby. And now, on that basis, how many people know about RZA? How many people don't know about RZA? Oh, there we go. Both of you, watch this.